out here in Newport, Vermont, a couple of days after Christmas on a Sunday morning, and we're going to do a little ice fishing. We're out here with Scott Wheeler and his boys, and Scott is a frequent contributor to the BackcountryJournal.com website. He also writes for the Chronicle, which is a publication up here. Scott has also made some contributions to Northeast Woods and Waters as well, so he's a pretty busy guy. We've just put a couple of holes in the ice and put some minnows on the hooks, and we're going to see what happens. It's about 7:30 a.m. And as you can see at this hour, there's already a little community of ice fishermen out here, people from both the U.S. and Canada. We're only a few miles from the Canadian border. And some come down here to fish for pleasure, others come down here to fish for meat. We were just at the bait shop and they were telling us how they'd collected over 2,000 pounds of fish that day, just by local fishermen out here catching fish, and it's sold, I suppose, to local supermarkets, restaurants, and so forth. And the fish that we're after is yellow perch, which is very delicious, especially when you catch it in the winter. And Scott has the first fish. Tell us what you're doing there, Scott.
Taking the fish's eye out and using that for bait instead of minnows.
So you find the fish eyes work pretty good as bait?
Yep, real good.
Perch. Wonderful. And I'm going to get a shot of this perch we just caught.
You're doing a shot.
See, okay, there we go. So what are we using for a technique here?
Luck.
Luck.
Not just bouncing it up and down. And missed.
So they're down there.
Got it? Missed them.
Okay, we're spending a few minutes here with one of the fishermen who's out on the lake this morning. And hi there, sir. What is your name?
Kirk Calero.
Hi there. Have you been coming out here quite a bit this winter?
Well, since Monday.
Since Monday?
Yeah.
And what have you been catching here?
Perch.
Perch?
Yep.
That's the primary species that's out here this time of year?
Yes. Yep.
Okay.
Yep.
And you've been doing this for quite a few years?
Ever since I was about 12.
Is that right?
Yeah.
So you've been doing this all your life?
Yeah.
How do you find the fishing in these recent years compared to in previous years?
Not so good.
Not so good?
No.
Wow.
No. It's changed over the last 20 years.
Yep.
Yeah.
Any thoughts as to how it's changed or why it's changed? Or
we're not getting as many as we used to.
Yep.
And the sizes are gone down.
They're not as big as they used to be?
No.
Well,
I don't think this new law is helping anything.
Oh, no.
Because they're going to overstock the lakes a lot bigger than they already have.
Oh, so they won't have a chance to grow as big?
Right.
Okay.
Because if you can only keep 20 pounds of fish, you're not going to keep 5-inch fish. You're going to throw them by. You're going to keep the 50 big ones.
So they'll be after the bigger fish?
Yeah.
And they'll clean those out, probably?
They'll clean the bigger ones out, and you're going to have just a little breeders left.
Yeah.
But we'll see in a few years. It
sure.
Won't take too many years.
Sure. What are your hopes as far as fishing today, as far as how many you'll catch and the size of some of the fish you think you might see?
Well, as it goes today, I just got one there for a bait.
Oh, yeah.
But I hope to get my limit, and that's 20 pounds.
20 pounds?
Yeah.
Wow. And that's pretty likely, or?
Well, for this week, it's been pretty likely in this area.
Good. Yeah. So this is a good producing area?
Yeah, for this time of year.
Yeah.
But they'll move out of here. It usually takes a week to move out of here, and they'll go back out into the main lake.
Yeah. So as the season changes, the fish move around and...
Yeah.
Wonderful. All right, well, I thank you for spending some time with us.
Thank you. That's what we're getting today.
There we go, yellow perch.
Yep.
Now, I know that in the summer, the perch seem to bite all throughout the day. Is it the same in the winter, or is in the winter, do they bite just in the morning, or in the mid-morning, or afternoon? Or?
They seem to bite better in the morning.
Yeah?
Depends on who you talk to.
Sure. And one of the keys with this is to keep moving and keep making new holes and keep experimenting, is that right?
What you do is you try to find a school of fish. And when they move, you move.
What kind of bait fish are we using for these?
Right now we're using minnows. That's pretty much what you use if you're not using fish eyes.
So you use the minnows to catch the first fish and then you start using the eyes?
Typically. Today minnows are working pretty good.
Now I've heard these referred to as perch minnows. How are perch minnows different from say, like a fathead minnow?
I don't think there's really a such thing as a perch minnow. I think all it is just referring to the size.
So it's the size of the minnow?
It's the size of the minnow, big enough for the perch to get it in your mouth.
Oh, yes.
Some of them bite hard, some of them just barely tug. Like that one hit hard.
Is he on there?
Yep.
There we go. Thank you. So tell us, Scott, a little bit about where we are as far as the name of this bay and if it has any kind of history at all.
Well, this is Prouty's Bay. It was named after Prouty's family who used to operate a large sawmill near here. They used to float the logs down Lake from Agog and in through the inlet, and they used to come down being pushed by barges. The trees were cut in Canada, and they came in here and sat here, I guess, until they were cut up. And there was a couple other mills along the shores here that also used logs. And during Prohibition, there was this one entrepreneur. what he had was a hollowed out log. When he came down from Canada, well, he'd bring it up to Canada, and then he'd bring it back down loaded with liquor. And once he got here into the bay, he'd unload it and sell it.
Huh.
Yep, put it back in.
And for the viewers who may be unfamiliar,
I've never caught a rock bass through the ice.
I've never seen one caught through the ice. That's all right.
Hey, boys. Nick. Never caught a rock bass through the ice. Never caught a rock bass through the ice.
And for our viewers who may be unaware, we're just a few miles from the Canadian border on Lake Memphremagog here in Newport, Vermont. And the majority of this lake, as I look north here, is in Canada, so this is a multi. This lake is in two countries, for lack of a better way to express it. So yeah, in the days of bootlegging and other kinds of smuggling, I'm sure that this is quite an active lake. And I wish my brother was here. He's going to be a little later. He has stories about how the Indians. This used to be somewhat of almost a highway. This lake. people going from Montreal and on down south, and they would just a way to travel and transport goods and things for trade.
It was the heart of the Abenaki homeland.
Oh, yes.
It was in the middle between two great rivers, between the Connecticut River and the St. Lawrence River in Quebec.